Good morning. I welcome all of you this morning on this glorious summer day. A few reminders about activities and events that are happening here at the church. A reminder that on Sunday, July 10th, will be our second annual Art Town Variety Show, where local talent will be highlighted here, and that takes place at 2 p.m. in the afternoon. Fellowship and Growth is assisting with that event, and they are asking for donations of homemade cookies for the Art Town event for the intermission and after. They will be available for a small fee, and the funds raised through the selling of those baked goods and water will go to the faith revenue line item budget in our budget. Also on Saturday, July 23rd, we once again will be taking part in Reno's Northern Nevada Gay Pride Parade. And so we are looking for those who would like to be part of our church's presence in both the parade as well as at the festival following the parade in Wingfield Park. We do have a booth that is set up with information about our church, and we encourage all who would like to walk. It's a joyous event, and the festival is just absolutely fantastic. Also, I was handed this morning, and it will be posted following worship, but Aaron Kirkpatrick is going to be in his first play, and that will take place on July 12th and 13th at 7 p.m. at the theater that is located on Keystone. So please take note of the times and the dates and the entrance fee as you leave this morning. But I think it would be fabulous if there were many of us from the church that are there to support Aaron in his first play / musical. Woohoo! Yeah, there you go. And now I have no other announcements, so please take a few moments to greet those who joined you for worship. Before we join together in our call to worship, there's one announcement that I forgot to announce, and that is that you may have noticed that the choir is on hiatus. And so if you have a musical gift that you would like to bless us with, there is a sign-up sheet for the Sundays that are available, or you can talk to Ted after the service. But we welcome all kinds of talents, as we were discussing: clowning, miming, singing, musical instruments. We are an all-inclusive church. So if you have a gift of a talent that you would like to share with us on Sunday mornings, I invite you to talk to Ted or sign up on the bulletin board outside of this church service.
Good morning, church. Please join me in the call to worship found in your bulletin. The way of our God is holy. Holy One, We seek your presence in our midst. The way of our God is wondrous. Wondrous God, we marvel at your works and marvelous deeds. The way of our God is awesome. Awesome God, we call out to you in hope. Please join us in the prayer of invocation. Liberating One, we keep you before us. Our souls rejoice and our hearts are gladdened. Our very beings find safety and security in our togetherness. We approach with thanksgiving and anticipation. Enliven us to be peacemakers in the world. Embolden us to live in freedom. Empower us to be good news. Stand up in us and show us the path of life. Amen. This morning's scripture reading is from 2 Kings. Now when the Lord was about to take Elijah up to heaven by a whirlwind, Elijah and Elisha were on their way from Gilgal. Elijah said to Elisha, "Stay here. for the Lord has sent me as far as Bethel. But Elisha said, as the Lord lives, and as you yourself live, I will not leave you. So they went down to Bethel. Then Elijah said to him, stay here, for the Lord has sent me to the Jordan. But he said, as the Lord lives, and as you yourself live, I will not leave you. So the two of them went on. 50 men of the company of prophets also went and stood at some distance from them as they both were standing by the Jordan. Then Elijah took his mantle and rolled it up and struck the water. The water was parted to the one side and to the other, and until the two of them crossed on dry land. When they had crossed, Elijah said to Elisha, tell me what I may do for you before I am taken from you. Elisha said, please, let me inherit a double share of your spirit. He responded, you have asked a hard thing, yet if you see me as I am being taken from you, it will be granted you. If not, it will not. As they continued walking and talking, a chariot of fire and horses of fire separated the two of them, and Elijah ascended in a whirlwind into heaven. Elisha kept watching and crying out, Father, Father, the chariots of Israel and its horsemen. But when he could no longer see him, he grasped his own clothes and tore them into two pieces. He picked up the mantle of Elijah that had fallen from him and went back and stood on the bank of Jordan. He took the mantle of Elijah that had fallen from him and struck the water, saying, where is the Lord, the God of Elijah? When he had struck the water was parted to the one side and to the other, and Elisha went over. May the Lord bless our hearing of today's word.
Okay, so Elisha, yeah? What are the differences? Yeah, very powerful, right? Thank you. Sorry, I don't know what's right? But trained, mature, powerful, bursting with the Holy Spirit, less trained, less mature, bursting with the Holy Spirit, right? So Elisha is an apprentice of Elijah. Elijah's a prophet. So prophets, as you know, were people in the Old Testament primarily who talked to God, who performed the works of God. They did things like teach about God and foretell, make prophecies about what was coming. But then they also did some miracles like Jesus. So there were times where the prophets were involved when water arrived or when oil to cook with arrived, or food arrived, or people were healed. So kind of the Jesus-type miracles as well. So we're going to do a relay race, which is a little tricky when one student pretending to be 12 came to Sunday school today. It is, after all, summer vacation. But here's what's going to happen. So in this scripture, Elijah passes on the mantle to Elisha. So the mantle was probably a cloak, right? Like Pastor Kate wears a robe. The mantle was probably a cloak, but it also represented Elijah's power. And Elisha says, I'm going to take on your role when Elijah's being called to God. And Elijah says, what can I do for you? And Aaron, do you remember what Elisha asked for? Two times, double up the spirit, double up the power, give me more. Well, with more power comes more responsibility. So here's what I need you to do. We, Aaron and I, agreed that you are starting with the mantle. So if you will take the mantle here, and this is a relay race. So Pastor Kate, what you need to do is you need to go get the items on the right side one at a time. There's water, peanut butter, beans, and vitamins. You need to go get the water. You have a bag. Put it in the bag. Bring it back to Aaron. Pass him the mantle. Aaron, you then take the bag and go get the peanut butter. Bring it back. Pass the mantle to Pastor Kate. All right? So you're going to trade up, but just the things on the right side. Are you ready?
He's not getting the left stuff. Both of you are getting the right side only this time. Okay? Are you ready? On your mark, get set, go. And she's going, and she's off, and she's grabbing the water. There she goes. No, wait. Stop. You must pass the mantle. Put the peanut butter back. Take it back to Aaron. Pass in the mantle and the bag. Aaron, now you go get the next thing. Bring it back. I know, it was Mike. Pass the mantle and the bag. Go. Excellent. All right, now we've got it. Now we're cooking, right? We're moving right along past the mantle and the bag. All right, well done. And he's off. And pretty easy peasy, right? Now let's pass Aaron the mantle. Aaron, you do the right side by yourself. All by yourself. You do. You ready? You got it? He's got it. Has he got it? I'm sure he's got it. Ready? Go. Go, Aaron. Go. All right. Well done. And he's back and he's going again. Thank goodness we got someone with long legs. Can you imagine Annie doing this? Okay. Go. Excellent. Oh, almost there. Yeah, don't trip. Excellent job. Is there still a bottle of vitamins back there? Okay, one last one. And you've got it. Well done. You got double the power. Was it twice as much work? Yeah. So sometimes when we ask for twice as much, we get twice as much power. We also get twice as much responsibility. Well done. Thanks, everybody. Okay. Good job, Aaron.
There is a candle in every soul, some burning brightly, some dark and cold. There is a spirit who brings a fire, ignites a candle, and makes his home. Carry your candle, run to the darkness, seek out the hopeless, confused and torn. Hold out your candle for all to see it. Take your candle and go light your world. Take your candle and go light your world. Frustrated brother, see how he's tried to light his own candle some other way. See now your sister, she's been robbed and lied to, still holds a candle without a flame. Carry your candle, run to the darkness, seek out the lonely, the tired and worn. Hold out your candle for all to see it. Take your candle and go light your world. Take your candle and go light your world. We are a family whose hearts are blazing. So let's raise our candles and light up the sky. Praying to our Father in the name of Jesus, make us a beacon in darkest time. Carry your candle, run to the darkness, seek out the helpless, deceived and poor. Hold out your candle for all to see it. Take your candle and go light your world. Take your candle and go light your world. Go light your world.
Thank you so much, Mark and Jackie, for sharing your gift and blessing us with your talent this morning. Let us pray. Oh God, may the words of my mouth and the meditations of our hearts be acceptable in your sight this morning. Amen. The story of Elijah and Elisha is a beautiful fable of the passing on of a lineage to another, with a literal passing on of a mantle. Elisha knows that his mentor, his guide, his master, and father figure isn't going to be around forever. In fact, Elijah's time has come. Elijah, such a central figure in the imagination of Israel's faith, doesn't merely die. He is taken up into heaven to be with God. His prophetic ministry, his meaning and his purpose have been divinely authorized up until this point. Now, though, it's time for him to retire. And he is swept up into a new life and calling. God doesn't usually whisk presidents, pastors, church leaders, and other workers up to the heavenly realm upon their retirement. Nor do their successors generally actually pick up their articles of clothing. Yet this is the story of Elijah and Elisha, and we need to get beyond explaining the impossibilities of this tale to the truth that actually lies behind it. Now, it's a tough call whether it's harder to be the one leaving or harder to be the one left behind. The one leaving is heading into the unknown, and the one left behind is returning to the known, but without the person who made the known make sense. So who will carry on the purpose and the prophetic voice when Elijah, the man, is gone? Well, Elisha is the top candidate, the favorite son, Elijah's most trusted disciple, the one who is to receive this blessing. Now, Elisha is unsure about his ability to take up the mantle and carry on the tough call to speak for God in the middle of injustice and political power games, always bending the world towards greater wealth for some and suffering for many. So Elisha says to Elijah, make mine a double. He asked for a double portion of spirit. He didn't mean whiskey, although he might have wanted a double scotch on the rocks as he felt his nerves tremble. He asks for a double portion of spirit, the same spirit that had empowered and enlivened Elijah. He appears to be a little unsure that he's got what it takes to carry on that ministry. Now, we know that in the best of situations, fathers pass on spirit to their sons and daughters, mothers to daughters and sons, mentors to disciples, professors to students. It is inevitable, and it haunts these relationships throughout their tenure because the older one must die or move on, and the younger must pick up that mantle, do the things that the father, mother, teacher did. The spirit, the authority, the empowerment must be passed on and must be taken up with courage. Elisha sees Elijah mysteriously taken up into the sky, into the infinite beyond. But he can't keep staring up there. The chariot of fire gets in the way, and we can't keep staring up, waiting for the one who taught us and loved us, encouraged us to come back and make it all better. It's like Elijah is somewhere beyond the sun, but if Elisha keeps staring at the sun, the fiery chariot in the sky, to see or wait for what's next, he'll just go blind. He must start living and trusting that spirit in himself. Well, Elisha tears his clothes, and he grieves the loss of his spiritual leader. He must grieve. It's part of the process. But he must also face the real fear of picking up that mantle. When he does stop staring into heaven and picks it up, he finds himself doing the things that Elijah did. He begins to trust that the same spirit at work in his mentor is now at work in him, and maybe even doubly so. He continues with the blessing of the mentor, his teacher, and he knows it. This year marks 34 years that I have been in the ministry. In January of 1988, after finishing seminary, I became the pastor of Ravenswood United Church of Christ in Chicago, Illinois. 34 years and four churches later, I marvel and celebrate that I have managed to stay this long in the ministry, and that even as I have remained, my ministry has taken me down wondrous paths that I could hardly have imagined 34 years ago. And I remember my ordination. Those who stood with me, those who laid hands upon me, giving me their blessing. My mentors, Reverend Maynard Beamer and Reverend Dow Edgerton, along with a circle of fellow seminarians, friends, and family who had mentored and mantled me for ministry. Now, whether or not we are ordained, we are all part of a lineage. We are here because someone, most likely many someones, told us a story that compelled us, that called us to follow in the way of Jesus. I offer gratitude this morning for those who told me that story, who lived that story, and who continue to provide strength and sustenance and guidance on the path for all of us. Whatever shape our ministry takes, however our faith is lived out, I hope that we will take up the mantle again and again and again, claiming it anew and walking with wisdom and hope and telling the story as we go. And so this morning, my blessing for you is, make no mistake, the blessing comes like hands laid upon your head, a mantle draped across your shoulders. You do not bear it alone. Think of it as lineage, as litany, as ancient legacy, entwining you among the strands that weave through generations and centuries, that spiral with enduring and determined grace of the story that has seized you and the one who has claimed and called you. Take it up and know the presence of those who have passed this on to you, who encompass you, who enfold you, who go with you and release you into the keeping of the road that is your own and the one who has called your name. Pick up the mantle and pass on the spirit that fills you and empowers you to do great and small things of love and justice and mercy. Amen. As we come before God in prayer, I lift up the prayers from this community. Bob is asking for prayers for Caleb, his step-grandson, who underwent surgery yesterday. And June is asking for prayers for her friend Barbara, who has recently had a kidney transplant and now has COVID. And I believe that this is Vi, who is asking for prayers for his uncle, Reverend Tanoha, who passed away last week. He's asking for prayers for his wife and children and family. Let us surround these people with our prayers of comfort and support and strength during these difficult times. And I wish to lift up Carol Buckman, who has been diagnosed with cancer and is awaiting the next steps in how to treat that. Let us pray. O great and loving God, today we ask for double the spirit that you have granted to those prophets of old. For truly, in this world that is torn apart by hatred and division and war, we need double the spirit, to go forth and tell the story of the good, great news that is found in following the way of Jesus. Help us, O God, to have the strength to pick up the mantle for justice, for love, and for mercy. For this world surely needs those who can shine forth that light that can break even the darkest of nights. Oh God, hear us now as we lift to you our personal and silent prayers, joys, and concerns for ourselves and for others. God, we lift these prayers to you in the name of Jesus, who taught us to pray. Our Creator, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. Invite you now to offer a portion of your blessings to God to be used by this church to reach out to our city, our state, this country, and the world.
Thank you.
Go forth now, pick up the mantle, and be those who can speak the story of God's love, God's mercy, and God's desire for justice in this world. Amen.